Welcome. My name is Cindy Michael, and I understand you're a Kiwanis Club treasurer, and you're interested in taking a look at MoneyMinder. Thanks for joining me today. You know, as a Kiwanis Club treasurer, it's going to be super important that one of the first things you do is find software that helps you really easily do your job and also provide good reporting and good record keeping so that you can portray a really sound, financially responsible organization. That's going to be really attractive to prospective members. They want to come and serve and volunteer for groups that are on stable footing. So finding that software is just one of the steps, and I might be a little biased, but I think MoneyMinder both makes it easy and super accurate. So let me walk you through just how simple it is to set up an account and manage your books with MoneyMinder. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to come to moneyminder.com. And in the upper right-hand corner, if your group already has an account with MoneyMinder, you're going to click the login button and enter your credentials to get logged into your account. But if you don't have an account, you're going to want to set up a free trial. And this is a 30-day free trial. There's no obligation. We don't ask for a credit card to get started. You just provide us a few pieces of information and you'll be off and running. So let's go through the steps. I'm going to click on free trial. I'm going to come down here and I'm going to click on sign up. Going to put in a few pieces of information. It's going to ask me for my name next. And I'm going to click next after that password. Now I'm going to set up the name of my organization. Now this is just a demo account, so I'm going to call it a demo. We are a service group. Put in my phone number and my address. And I'm going to click next. And now it's going to ask me for my financial year start date. And most Kiwanis clubs have a financial year start of October 1st. And I'm going to click I'm not a robot and sign up. And now I get to log in. That was it for the steps to get in. Once I get in here, it's going to ask me one more time if that financial year start that I said it was is really correct. And the reason for this is because it's super important from reporting perspective, especially for the IRS, that we get this date correct. We don't want to be reporting for a different period of time than the IRS is expecting us to report on. So this section just talks about why it's important. If you don't know when your financial year starts, this section gives you some ideas about where you can find that date. It's always going to be the first of a month. And like I said, most Kiwanis Club groups are on an October 1st start. So once we know this is right, we're going to click next. I'm going to set up this account today with today's date in mind. So I want it to be the current financial year we're sitting in right now. So I'm going to choose 2020 and click create. This brings us into MoneyMinder. So the first things you're going to do in MoneyMinder are set up both your bank accounts and your budget. And they're both super easy. Most Kiwanis clubs have at least two bank accounts, if not three, for their groups. Most of them have an administrative account and a service account. And some of them also have a foundation account. So I'm going to set up these bank accounts. And I'm just going to make up a starting balance right now for these accounts. If this were in real life, you would take your statement balance from your bank statement at the beginning of the financial year that you're in. So in this case, it would be on October 1st, 2020. And I'd put that number here based on my bank statement. But again, we're just kind of making it up right now to get started. So I'm going to add a service account as well. And I'm also today going to add a foundation account. Okay, and I'm going to save that. And now we have our three bank accounts set up here. And if I go to my homepage, I'm going to see those same three accounts set up here with those starting balances that I entered. The next step is going to be to set up a budget. So if I click this button right here, I can choose to either choose a template from the list here as my starting point and work from there, or I can just start from scratch. And I just want to start from scratch today. So this is completely customizable to your group. And so you're going to take the budget that your group has worked up tentatively, and you're going to put it in here so that all the headings and categories, or what some other software calls your chart of accounts, is all here and pertains to your group. So I'm going to make a few things up here. I'm going to put in the heading of administrative, and then I'm going to put some items below it, things that we are probably going to be bringing money in on or spending money on. So bear with me while I type a few of these in and make up some numbers that might seem reasonable. So you're going to notice that in this case right here, installation, I might be charging members for some installation fees as well as spending money on this activity. And MoneyMinder allows me to put that in the same line. So my budgeted income and budgeted expenses. This is really handy when it comes to reporting later, where you have all of your information on the same line for a group, as opposed to having it split out as income and expenses. And I'll show you that when we come to reports later. But for now, I'm going to save my changes here. And then I'm going to go into another account here that actually has a budget fully worked out. So that saved you the heartache of watching me type in all of these items. So we have our budget in here. It looks like what I want. We can amend this later. We just click on the budget icon right here, and you can come in and you can change any of these numbers at any point in time if you choose to amend your budget. So let's go to the homepage now. Let's see what it looks like now. Now we have our bank account still, and we have all of our headers. This is just the summary financial overview. And I also went ahead and put in some real data so that we could start looking at how data looks compared to budget. And we can run some reports and start making sense of things. Most of the time when you're working in MoneyMinder, you're going to be entering transactions. And that's basically entering deposits and withdrawals. So things that you're bringing money in for and spending money on. And so I'm going to click on this administrative account. I have some fake data in here to look at. These are all transactions I've entered on behalf of my group. So if I click edit on something here, I can see that I wrote check number 1551 on this date to this company for this amount of money. I applied it to this particular category because it was something that I paid for, some product I paid for this fundraiser, okay? And at any time, we can see our bank register for the activity that's happened in that bank account. One of the nice things about MoneyMinder is that you can either choose to enter transactions by hand, or you can add bank integration to your account. It's an extra $39 a year, and that allows you to import transactions directly from your bank account. So in this case, I have a bank account hooked up to my foundation account. So I'm going to go on in here, and I'm going to show you what importing a transaction will look like. Right here, I see that I have something available to be imported, $2,500. I'm going to click import, and rather than keying all the information in that it could grab from my bank account, it just auto-populated it for me. I'm going to apply this to as a donation to the foundation account, and I'm going to click save and close. And now it's going to show up as being imported. And if I go to my bank register, I can also see that it was imported and I now have a bigger balance. That's nice. So a lot of your work is done within the bank accounts, like I said, entering transactions. But once you have that done, then you get to report to your group. And if I click on reports up here, you can see that there are lots of reports that you can choose from. One of the most common reports to take to a board meeting is this treasurer's report right here. And that dummy data that I filled in earlier, I did that so you can kind of get a sense of how these reports read. And this is going to show you why that budget was so interesting and helpful to you, the way we set things up. So I can see, for example, that during this period of time from October 1, 2020 to September 30th, 2021, this is the activity that's taken place so far for my group. And I can see, for example, that I paid $496.50 for insurance. I can see that we had budgeted $500, so I'm ahead by $3.50. Yay. Likewise, I can see down here, brags and boasts. We brought in $1,645 for the year so far. We are budgeted to bring in $2,000. And looks like we have another $355 to bring in yet for the year. Now, let's say I wanted to get more information about this brags and boasts. What is that comprised of, for example? I'm going to go back to the reports area, and I'm going to look at that particular category. I'm going to choose brags and boasts and apply that filter. And it's going to tell me all of the deposits that took place against brags and boasts. So these are all the transactions that happened to total that $1,645. So you can see that you can get a lot of information here. Most of our reports are exportable to PDF and Excel. So you can always take those and manipulate those in other ways, or you can send them to people via email if you want. They're pretty handy to be able to do that. Some other features in MoneyMinder that are super useful are contacts, for example. In this case, I just have myself in here. So I can track how much money a particular member has given me or that we've paid. And we can keep track of things like member activity, donor activity, how much we've reimbursed them. We have a variety of ways we can capture that data. But in this case, I just have myself set up as a member. And I've applied a couple of obligations to myself. I've said that I'm going to owe annual dues this year of $200. And I have an induction fee of $50. And then I made some payments. So I have my obligations right here. And then it's going to show the payments that I made against that $250, which is really helpful to see where a person stands. You can see right now I owe $50. Now, the other nice thing is I can compose a statement to send to a member that shows that exact information. And I can choose the date range I want to show for any particular person. And I can email this to somebody directly. So this is a great way to manage your contacts. Now, if I go back to banking, let's go back and look at that administrative account. And I'm going to look at the deposit right here. I just happen to know that that's the deposit that reflects my activity. So what happened here is when I gave $200 to my group, I came in and I divvied that up, or I split that up to show how much goes to each category. So that reflects back on my treasurer's report. Let's come back down here and look at our membership here. So that shows that 100 of that 200 went toward club membership dues, 52 went to international dues, and 48 went to the district dues. So that's pretty slick how you can split out transactions. Okay, so some other features that are really super useful for MoneyMinder users is a documents area. You can upload documents so that you have one central place to organize things. That way, if you ever need them really quickly, you can find them. So I happen to have mine split up with bank statements and bylaws and IRS correspondence and meeting minutes. You can do whatever you want. For example, in IRS documents, I have our letter of determination scanned and put in here. That's often really helpful to put your fingers on pretty quickly. And so you can use this section however you'd like, and you can store lots of documents here to make things easier on everybody. Tax forms is another really helpful area for a lot of people. If you have to file a 990N or a 990EZ down the road, this section will help you with that. It won't completely do the job for you, but it will auto-populate your totals that are based on the information you've entered into MoneyMinder. So you can auto-populate that, and you'll download this to your desktop, sign it, and send it in when it's all filled out. That's pretty easy. And then at the end of the year, when you are done being the treasurer and you're outgoing and ready to pass this on to the next treasurer, it's super easy. If you click on the account button up here, scroll down to the bottom, you can click on add new user and just put in somebody's name and email address in here, choosing their access rights. So if it's a new treasurer, you probably want to give them administrative access. This will send an invite to them via their email address, and they can set up a password and log on in. And that's how easy the transition is. When you're all when you've got them all trained up, you can just have them take you off as a user on the account, or maybe change you to reporting user if you still need to take a look at things. But that's how easy it is. You can have as many users as you want on the account. You can see all different levels of membership, or of access. Pretty slick. So we also have a store, which is super nice. If you don't want to set up PayPal or Square, this lives with your account. And you can collect donations, membership, fundraising money, you name it, all within the store. You can get more information about this with our by clicking on the link here. Or you can always ask our support team for help. We offer free support from our expert superheroes. They've all walked in your shoes as a volunteer treasurer themselves at one point. So reach out if you need help, either getting started or understanding things. And that's pretty much MoneyMinder in a nutshell. So what are you waiting for? Go ahead and get your free 30-day trial set up today and get started. And let us help you make your life as treasurer super easy.